Welcome back. In the previous class, we are discussing about the rain gauge station. What is meant by rain gauge station? The place where rain gauge is installed and the rainfall measurement is carried out is called a rain gauge station. To install a rain gauge, minimum plot of size 5.5 meters into by 5.5 meters is required. Level ground open to sky is required. Minimum distance between the gauge and the nearest object is 30 meters or twice the height of the object, whichever is more. So these are the requirements to place a rain gauge. So next, coming to the density of the rain gauge network, that means how many number of rain gauges are required for a particular area, that is called density. Number of rain gauges per given area is called rain gauge density or density of a rain gauge network. For plain and flat catchment, one rain gauge for 520 km² and for elevated above 1000 meters, one rain gauge for 260 to 390 km². Mountains and hilly regions, one rain gauge for 130 km². Optimum number of rain gauges is denoted with a small n. Required will be calculated. So let us take a precipitation P1, P2, Pn up to till M stations. We are taking the precipitation at M stations, be the rainfall values recorded at the existing rain gauge stations 1, 2, 3 and so on till M respectively. By subjecting the rainfall data recorded at M, number of existing stations to statistical analysis, optimum number of rain gauges N can be determined for a given percentage of allowable permissible error E. Step 1. How to find mean? You have to find the mean of the rainfall data given. If you are having M stations, you have to calculate the mean rainfall data of the M station. How you will calculate the mean data? Summation of the total precipitations of different M stations by total number of stations will give you the mean of the rainfall data. And you have to calculate the standard deviation of the rainfall data. This is the formula for standard deviation, where Pi is the particular station precipitation minus mean precipitation whole square by how many station, number of stations minus 1, and the summation of this will give you, under root of the summation will give you the standard deviation. So find the coefficient of variation. So you have to find the coefficient of variation, which is denoted with the CV, that is equal to 100 sigma by P bar, where sigma is the standard deviation, P bar is the mean precipitation. For a given allowable error, somewhat error will be there, everything should not be in accuracy due to some errors, environmental atmospheric errors, they will happen, and the calculation of the number of rain gauges may not be accurate, but you can consider some of error. So if we include that error, the total optimum number of rain gauges required N is equal to CV by E whole square, where CV is the coefficient of variation, E is the error, allowable error whole square. So next, from this equation we can see that optimum number of rain gauges is inversely proportional to the error. That means if error is more, so number of rain gauges will be less. So these are the, based upon those equations we can derive these conditions. So we got n number of rain gauges, and we have already m number of rain gauges which we calculate the mean, right? So if the whatever the value you get n, which is less than the given number of rain gauges installed, are sufficient in number. If the n is greater than the given rain gauge stations, you have to install more number of rain gauges. So additional number of rain gauges can be calculated from the equation n minus m. Accuracy can be calculated, 100 minus error will give you the percentage of accuracy. So these are the problems which we have can do based upon these equations. So preparation of, so we got the rainfall data based upon the rainfall will be calculated using rain gauge stations. So rain gauge stations where we have to keep VC and how many number of rain gauge stations also VC. So we have installed a number of rain gauges and we have collected the rain precipitation. We got the depth of the precipitation. So next task for us is to prepare the rainfall data. You have to exhibit the data in some other form. So how you will represent this data, we'll see. Before using the rainfall data in the hydrological analysis, data is verified with the following conditions: continuity, consistency. You have to check for the continuity and you have to check for the consistency. That means every rain gauge station in a particular area is working or not. If all are working, then that is in continuity. If anything is missing, for any error occurred, that rain gauge station which we have installed, any one of the rain gauge station we installed is not working, so then we can say that it is not a continuity, not in continuity. So data should be continuous without any broken information, and data should be truly representative of the region, consistent. So if there is no continuity, we have to calculate the missing data rainfall. So these are the stations given. These are the given stations P1, P2, PM. Rain precipitations be the rainfall values recorded at the adjacent. So missing station, I am taking it as X, was missed in the rainfall data. So these normal precipitation values are the rainfall values which have been taken by past 30 years latest average rainfall data. By this average 30 years latest rainfall data, we will get the N1, N2, NX and NM. So if in the particular year X station is not giving the data, in the past 30 years it may have given in the data. So based upon that one, we can calculate the normal annual precipitation of the data. So there are some steps, some procedures to calculate the precipitation of the particular year X at particular station X. So simple mean method is this simple mean method is used when normal values are equal for every station. If we calculate it, for example, I have taken one station, I have taken the past 30 years data, and I have taken another station and I have calculated the past 30 years data. So if that past 30 years data for those both the stations is equal, then we can use this simple mean method. And approximately we can take plus or minus 10%, that is not the matter. So approximately we can allow 10 plus or minus 10%. So then we can use this method. If the normal values are not equal to missing data station, that error is a missing data station error is plus or greater than or less than plus or minus 10%, then we have to go for the normal ratio method. The formula for this method is Px is equal to Nx by M into P1 by N1 plus P2 by N2 plus Pm by Nm. So in this, using these two methods, we will calculate the missing data. While working missing data, rainfall data at any station, rainfall data of all adjacent station lying in the same climatic zone is considered. So with this, I will end this session. These are the problems related to the missing data station using simple mean method and the normal ratio method.